We know that tank circuit is very much necessary in case of oscillator circuits. What happens if a bridge network is used as a tank circuit in oscillators? Let us see in this session about that concept. The concept is very much interesting, that is Wien bridge oscillator. Before learning Wien bridge oscillator, let us learn about principle of lead lag network. What is meant by this lead lag network? Enidu lead lag network anta andre, look at here. In the previous academic year, we studied about two kinds of filters. One is RC high pass filter, the other one is RC high pass filters. We studied these two, RC low pass filter and RC high pass filter, in the previous academic year. The RC high pass filter, let us start with this. RC high pass filter it looks like this. It consists of a resistor and a capacitor which are connected like this. We apply input signal across the series combination of capacitor and the resistor, and we take the output across the resistor. So here we apply the input voltage Vi, and here we measure the output voltage Vo. We call this as a RC high pass filter because this passes only high frequency signals, because low frequency signals are blocked by this capacitor. And we learnt one more interesting and important thing while studying this concept, that is in this circuit output voltage leads the input voltage by an angle phi. Similarly, in RC low pass filter, we studied that output is lagged behind the input by an angle phi. We also here output leads the input by an angle phi. Here output lagged behind the input by an angle phi. We also say the same thing in different manner. That means in case of this network is also known as lead network, this network is known as lag network. We say this leading phenomena in different manner here. Enanta heltivi antandre, phase angle is negative in case of lead network, phase angle is positive in case of lag network. So ee tara navu illi helkolta hogtivi. So this is lead network and this is lag network. If we combine both of them in a systematic manner, then the resultant network is lead lag network. Let us see what happens, how it looks like a lead lag network, how it looks like. Let us construct a lead lag network here. Let me have a capacitor first at the input, let me call it as C1, and let me have a resistor, let it be R1. Now let me have a parallel combination of resistor and capacitor here. This is capacitor C2 and this is resistor R1. Look at here, we apply input voltage at this part, and we'll measure the output at this part. Illi output na now measure madkoltivi. Here this is Vi. Here low frequency signals are blocked by C1. Low frequency signals are blocked by C1 because for low frequency signal, capacitor C1 acts like a open switch. But for high frequency signals, C1 behaves like a closed switch. Similarly, capacitor C2 also behaves like a closed switch. Therefore, current bypassed to ground via C2. Similar, therefore, what happens? Low frequency signals are blocked by C1 and high frequency signals are bypassed to crown by C2. Means this network never pass the low frequency signals and also high frequency signals. Only those signals which are with the frequency f is equal to 1 divided by 2 pi r and c. So this frequency, we call it as the resonating frequency. Only the resonating frequency, or we can also call it as an intermediate frequency. This intermediate frequency is passed by this network. Here the question is how to take the value of R. Simple, this R is equal to R1 is equal to R2. And similarly, C is equal to C1 is equal to C2. So whichever the frequency obeys this criteria, or whichever the frequency is resulted due to the combination of this formula, passes through this network very effectively. Rest of the frequencies are attenuated, or they blocked, or they gets blocked or attenuated. So this is the principle of lead lag network. Here in this network we can also say that for low frequencies for low frequencies phase angle is negative, for high frequencies phase angle will be positive. At this resonating frequency phase angle will be zero. So phase angle must be zero. Why? Because one among the Barkhausen criteria says that phase angle should be 0 or 360 degree. For an amplifier to become an oscillator, the phase angle should be 0. Idanna now odidvi Barkhausen criteria na study maduvaga. This is about principle of lead lag network. Now let us move on to Wien bridge oscillator. Before moving into the concept, let us learn what is meant by a Wien bridge. Wien bridge antandre eno? So before studying about Wien bridge, let us learn what is meant by a bridge. Bridge is a kind of electrical network. In which two electrical branches are bridged by the third branch, which is connected at intermediate parts of remaining two branches. That means here I have a branch which contains so many circuit elements. This is one branch which contains two circuit elements. I don't know which are those circuit elements, but there are certain circuit elements. This is branch 1 and this is branch 2. Branch 1, branch 2. These two branches are bridged by third branch. This is branch 3. Branch 3 is acting like a bridge between branch 1 and branch 2. Branch 1 mathe branch 2 madhe the third branch bridge tara act aagta ide. So this kind of network is known as bridge network. Idanna bridge network anta karitare. There are so many bridges in electronics. Popular among them is Wien bridge. Let us see how a Wien bridge is constructed. So Wien bridge, it is constructed by using resistors and capacitors. This is one branch. This is R4 and this is R3. This is R1, this is C1, this is R2, this is C2. This is branch 1 and this is branch 2. In between these two branches, I am connecting one more element as a bridge. One more element as a bridge. This is when I connect a resistor here. So this becomes the Wien bridge. This becomes the Wien bridge. Here, in place of resistor, I'll connect an op amp. Illandu op amp anna connect martini. Hege, this is connected to inverting terminal. This is connected to inverting terminal. This is connected to non-inverting terminal. So this is plus VCC. This is minus VEE. So this now this becomes Wien bridge. Idenaitido Wien bridge. So this Wien bridge, this is actually Wien bridge oscillator na circuit. So ithara bridge irodrinda idike Wien bridge oscillator anta karkondru. Now let us see how a Wien bridge oscillator is properly constructed. ಒಂದು ವೀನ್ ಬ್ರಿಜ್ ಆಸಿಲೇಟರ್ ನ ಹೇಗೆ ಕನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅನ್ನೋದು. ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ದಿಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಅ ವೀನ್ ಬ್ರಿಜ್ ಆಸಿಲೇಟರ್. ಲೆಟ್ ಮಿ ಗಿವ್ ದ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ ಫಿನಿಷಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಲೆಟ್ ಮಿ ಡ್ರಾ ಅ ವೀನ್ ಬ್ರಿಜ್ ಆಸಿಲೇಟರ್ ಸರ್ಕ್ಯೂಟ್. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಓಪ್ ಆಂಪ್, ಲೆಟ್ ಮಿ ಡ್ರಾ ದ ಓಪ್ ಆಂಪ್. ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ಲೆಟ್ ಮಿ ಕನೆಕ್ಟ್ ಅ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟರ್ ವಿಚ್ ಈಸ್ ಆರ್ ಫೋರ್ as VCC minus VEE, and this is R3. This is R2 and C2. This is R1 and this is C1. Let me connect the output device such as CRO. Here. This is the Wien bridge oscillator network. Here we get the output voltage V0. According to Bark-Hassan criteria, to get the effective oscillation, phase angle creation by the circuit must be 0 degree. Phase angle creation must be 0 degree. The frequency for the to get the such a kind of frequency, we must get the resonating frequency to achieve the 0 degree phase angle. The frequency generated should be resonating frequency. So resonating frequency generate aadaga namage enagutte 0 degree phase angle iruvantaha output bartha hogutte. But the thing is to get the resonating frequency, the bridge must be balanced. The bridge balancing there should be a certain condition. What is that condition? Condition yenu annodu naavu nortta hogana. Here we have two resistors, that is R3 matte R4. R1, R2, R3, R4 ನಾಲ್ಕು ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ಗಳಿದೆ. ಸೊ ಬ್ರಿಡ್ಜ್ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸಿಂಗ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಏನಾಗಿರಬೇಕು, ಬ್ರಿಡ್ಜ್ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಗಬೇಕು ಅಂತಂದರೆ ನಾವು ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟರ್ ವಿ ಮಸ್ಟ್ ಚೂಸ್ ದ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟರ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂಸ್. ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಸಿ ವಾಟ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ದ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಆಫ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟರ್. ವಿ ಮಸ್ಟ್ ಚೂಸ್ ದ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಸೋ ದಟ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಅಂದರೆ ಈ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟರ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂಸ್ ಯಾವ ಥರ ಚೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿರಬೇಕು ಅಂದರೆ ದ ರೇಷಿಯೋ ಆಫ್ R3 ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ R4 ratio of R3 and R4 should be equal to R1 divided by R2 plus R1 divided by R2 plus C2 divided by C1 ಆಗಿರಬೇಕು. So if this condition, if the sum of ratio of R1 and R2 and C2 and C1. So if the sum of these ratios is equal to the ratio of R3 and R4, then we say that bridge is balanced. Bridge balance anta yavaga helabodu anta andre ee eradu resistor gala ratio, ee eradu capacitor gala ratio, ee eradu ratio gala sum ಯಾವುದಕ್ಕೆ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಆಗಿರಬೇಕು? ಈ ಎರಡು ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟರ್ಗಳ ರೇಷಿಯೋಗೆ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಆಗಿರಬೇಕು. ಇಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಈಕ್ವೇಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಸ್ಯಾಟಿಸ್ಫೈಡ್, ಇಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಈಕ್ವೇಷನ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆಫ್ R1, R2, R3, R4 ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ C2 ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ C1 ಆರ್ ಚೋಸನ್ ಸೋ ದಟ್ ಇಫ್ ದ ರಿಲೇಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಸ್ಯಾಟಿಸ್ಫೈಡ್, ದೆನ್ ವಿ ಸೇ ದಟ್ ಬ್ರಿಡ್ಜ್ ಈಸ್ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ಡ್. ಇಫ್ ದ ಬ್ರಿಡ್ಜ್ ಈಸ್ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ಡ್, then we'll get the resonating frequency. If the resonating frequency is generated, then we get the sustained oscillation. We can make it much more simple. It's very easy. Hegeppa antandre, if we choose R1 is equal to R2 is equal to R and C1 is equal to C2 is equal to C, again agibidutte equation R3 divided by R4 equal to 2 ಅಂತ ಆಗಿಬಿಡುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಆ ಥರ ಕೂಡ ನಾವಿಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾಡಬಹುದು, ಗೊತ್ತಾಯ್ತಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ಹಾಗೆ ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ದ ಎಫೆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಆಸಿಲೇಷನ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಫ್ರೀಕ್ವೆನ್ಸಿ ಆಫ್ ಆಸಿಲೇಷನ್ನ ಹೇಗೆ ಮೆಷರ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಅಂತ ಅಂದರೆ, ಸೊ ಫ್ರೀಕ್ವೆನ್ಸಿ ಆಫ್ ಆಸಿಲೇಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಬೈ ದಿಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಷನ್ ಎಫ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 1 ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ root 2π root of R1 C1 R2 C2 ಅಂತ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ. ಸಪೋಸ್ ನಾವಿಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವೇನು ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಅಂತಂದರೆ R1 ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು R2 ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು R ತೊಗೊಳ್ತೀವಿ, C1 ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು C2 ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು C ಅಂತ ತೊಗೊಳ್ತೀವಿ. ಹಾಗೇನಾಗುತ್ತೆ? ರೂಟ್ ಆಫ್ R² C² ಅಂತ ಆಗ್ಬಿಡುತ್ತೆ, ಆಯ್ತಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ಇಫ್ R1 ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು R2 ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು R ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಫ್ R1 ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು C1 ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು C2 ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು C ಆದರೆ ಈಕ್ವೇಷನ್ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ? ಆ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಮೂಮೆಂಟಲ್ಲಿ ಈಕ್ವೇಷನ್ನು ಎಫ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 1 ÷ 2π ರೂಟ್ ಆಫ್ R² ನೋಡಿ ಈ ಥರ ಬರುತ್ತೆ, R² C² ಅಂತ ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಅದನ್ನು ಸಿಂಪ್ಲಿಫೈ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ? ಸೊ ಈ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನಲ್ಲಿ ಸಿಂಪ್ಲಿಫೈ ಆದಾಗ ನಮಗೆ ಫೈನಲಿ ಉಳಿಯುವಂಥದ್ದು ರೂಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ಸಲ್ ಆಗಿ 2π ಇಂಟು RC ಅನ್ನೋ ಈಕ್ವೇಷನ್ ಉಳ್ಕೊಳುತ್ತೆ. ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಷನ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಫ್ರೀಕ್ವೆನ್ಸಿ ಜನರೇಟೆಡ್ ಬೈ ದಿಸ್ ಸರ್ಕ್ಯೂಟ್. ಸೊ ಪ್ರೊವೈಡೆಡ್ ದ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಆಫ್ R1 and R2 should be equal, C1 and C2 should be equal. Now, let us see the gain here. Gain ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ನಾವು ನೋಡ್ತಾ ಹೋಗಬೇಕಾಗತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಗೈನ್ ಈಕ್ವೇಷನ್ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಅಂತಂದರೆ, ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ಲೆಟ್ ಮೀ ಡ್ರಾ ದ ಈಕ್ವೇಷನ್ ಫಾರ್ ಗೈನ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ A is equal to 1 plus R3 divided by R4. ಸೊ ಯಾಕೆ ಈ ಥರ ಈಕ್ವೇಷನ್ ಬರದೆ ಅಂತಂದರೆ, ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ನೋಡಿ, ಲುಕ್ ಅಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್, ಇನ್ವರ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಟರ್ಮಿನಲ್ ಈಸ್ ಗ್ರೌಂಡೆಡ್ ಬಟ್ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಟು ಆರ್ ಫೀಡ್ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಸಿಗ್ನಲ್ ಈಸ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಟು ನಾನ್ ಇನ್ವರ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಟರ್ಮಿನಲ್. ಫೀಡ್ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಸಿಗ್ನಲ್ ಅಥವಾ ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಕೊಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ? ನಾನ್ ಇನ್ವರ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಟರ್ಮಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಕೊಡ್ತಿದ್ದೀವಿ. ದೇರ್ಫೋರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಒಪ್ಯಾಂಪ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಪರೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ನಾನ್ ಇನ್ವರ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಮೋಡ್. ದೇರ್ಫೋರ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ರಿಟನ್ ದ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಗೈನ್ ಆಫ್ ನಾನ್ ಇನ್ವರ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಆ್ಯಂಪ್ಲಿಫೈಯರ್, ಅದರದ್ದು ಈಕ್ವೇಷನ್ನ ಬರೆದಿದ್ದೀನಿ. ಬಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ನಾವಿಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಹೋಗ್ತೀವಿ ಅಂತಂದರೆ, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡಿ, R3 ÷ R4 ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 2 ಅಂತ ಬಂದಿತ್ತು. ಯಾಕೆ? ನಾವು ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡ್ವಿ, R1 ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು R2 ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು R ಮಾಡಿದ್ವಿ, ಹಾಗೆಯೇ C1 ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು C2 ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು C ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡ್ವಿ. ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ನಮಗೇನಾಯಿತು, R3 ÷ R4 ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 2 ಅಂತ ಬಂದಿತ್ತು. ಸೊ ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, A ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 1 ಪ್ಲಸ್ 2 is equal to 3 anta barutte. Inna let us see what is meant by what happens to beta. Beta ge enagutte anta nododadre naave enanta helkondidvi a beta is equal to 1 anta helidvi. So alige enaytu beta is equal to 1 divided by a anta agutte. So a value 3 bandirodrinda beta is equal to 1 divided by 3 anta barutte. So this is all about the theoretical part. This is all about the theoretical part of ವೀನ್ ಬ್ರಿಜ್ ಆಸಿಲೇಟರ್. ವೀನ್ ಬ್ರಿಜ್ ಆಸಿಲೇಟರ್ನ ಥಿಯರಿಟಿಕಲ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಈ ಥರ ಬರ್ತಾ ಹೋಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಇನ್ ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಸೆಷನ್ ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಲರ್ನ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಅಡ್ವಾಂಟೇಜಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಆರ್ ಸಿ ಆಸಿಲೇಟರ್ಸ್, ಡಿಸ್ಅಡ್ವಾಂಟೇಜ್ ಆಫ್ ಆರ್ ಸಿ ಆಸಿಲೇಟರ್ಸ್, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಲರ್ನ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ ಅಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಲಿಮಿಟೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಆರ್ ಸಿ